A little louder.
Rob and I just got into the Vancouver airport. It's 1:00, almost 2:00 in the afternoon, August 2nd. We're sitting in the business class lounge, waiting for a flight for 2 more hours yet. So we're having a glass of wine. Rob's having cheese and pickles. I had a couple cookies that were pretty good. And it's kind of rainy outside, so hopefully it's nice weather.
Well, it's 4:15 in the afternoon in Berlin. Donna just took a shower. I took a shower. And Donna wanted to take a nap. So, I'm going to let Donna nap for a while. Right, Donna?
Yep.
Well, we're in Mom's room, Mom and Dad's room right now. They're in room 720 right across in the hall. And when we got in, they just came up minutes before us.
Shower and change.
So, you know what? If we would have waited probably 10 minutes, we would have got off that same, you know, we'd have met at the station. Today.
You know, when we got those tickets, I got the children's tickets.
Yep.
You know, we were almost well, shit, we'll just go.
Yeah.
With those tickets.
Yeah.
Well, good thing we went and found the booth inside the thing, because when we connected at one of these other train stations, there was a man who was already on there, and as soon as the doors closed, he asked to see tickets. He was a big, burly man. So he was showing his S-Bahn card, showing that he worked for the thing, but that's a good thing we changed those tickets, because we could have said it was too much of a hassle to bother, and then we would have been fined.
Did he ask you for your ticket?
Yeah.
Oh, he did?
Yeah.
See, he's never asked it.
So that's why I'm saying it's a good thing we did it.
Yeah. I would never do it any other way. This morning, we got up at 5:30, and we went down for breakfast. The breakfast was very nice. We didn't go down to breakfast till 7 o'clock.
It was crowded?
It got crowded. By 8 o'clock, it was crowded. There was a lot of people. And there's a group of children here, of about, 16 of them. And they came in about 8 o'clock, you know, and so the best time to go for breakfast
Six.
Is early, because these kids sleep till late.
Kids are kids.
Yeah. But anyway, we ate breakfast. We took a long time eating breakfast because we talked, and then we came up here and took her and left, and I don't remember. We don't
figured out what routes we take, which buses.
Yeah, we didn't go by buses. We went by the S-Bahn. And then we went to the Bergen.
Brandenburg Gate.
Yeah, Brandenburg Gate. And we got off there after changing trains. There's no direct route. You have to change only once. And then we walked around there. And did they have the canvas on the gate? Well, they still have the canvas.
Yeah, they're supposed to be for the rest of the year or something.
Behind. And we worked around there. And it's true, it was muggy. And Mom thought that it would be a cold.
She wore jeans.
Well, this morning when we were having breakfast, we were sitting by the window. And I kept pointing up for Mom, look, people are walking around with no coats on. And yet it looked cold. And when we walked out, when you get out there and start walking, it's not cold, it was warm. And we walked all around there, and then we didn't even pay attention where we were going, just kept going. And then when we looked at the clock and we better head back for a year to meet you guys. And so we tried to look at our map and figure out where we were. And I couldn't, I didn't know where we were. I knew where we were on the street. I couldn't find it on here. So then I stopped in a camera office, and the guy said, oh yeah, he spoke English. And he said, yeah, I know. He says, you're right here. And we were only about 300 yards away from the S-Bahn, you know.
Yeah, once you find the S-Bahn, you can navigate by the other grid map.
Yeah, once you got the S-Bahn, you know.
U-Bahn or S-Bahn, you can go anywhere.
Yeah, we didn't take U-Bahn anywhere. We just took the S-Bahn. We just drove by S-Bahn. We've only been here today, and yesterday was the first day.
Good.
And now, when we got back here, we got off the train about 20 minutes after 3. What time did you guys get off? You probably didn't even look.
Quarter after 3.
You guys,
when we went down there, the woman said that a lady was just here asking if you were here.
Yeah.
When you say just, she was just here, what does that mean? 10 minutes, half hour ago?
Oh, no, it wasn't half hour.
Must have been right then.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
10 minutes. Because
we had just walked in, and Mom said, I'm taking a shower.
And the first thing I did was pull my clothes off, because I was so hot.
And I'm going to take a shower, and then you talked to me. Did you talk to me from across the room?
Yeah.
That's why you were so fast.
Well, yeah, and I knew that if I didn't radio you, you would say, well, why didn't you have your radio on?
That's
so Donna was going to knock, and I said, don't knock. Let me radio him first. So now I think we're going to go for a walk.
I've been having it on and trying to page you.
But yeah, I didn't want to be doing that on the train.
But I'll tell you
something. You want to do it discreetly.
I did it in the train stations. You know why? How can they tell
it's a cell phone.
Everybody has a cell phone here. So how could these be?
I didn't see that so much here. It's New York that everybody has a cell phone. And Los Angeles.
If there's enough space, he can go to.
Yeah.
But I'm like,
off
the
boat.
Yeah.
To see? The memorial, the Russian memorial.
Where all the Soviets are there.
The building.
Here. Yeah.
Whatever they're called.
She helped me.
People think I'm going through the garbage.
They thought that he took over, I forget.
Okay. Hearing.
You can't get into it.
Going over there?
Yeah. You go to
the communist
stuff,
yeah.
What do you think that signifies?
Unless we have to walk out.
The darkness? Yeah, I don't know what her name was.
Well, we had, like, you know, our own screen. So this is so cool.
Bombing this town. That guy's bombing.
The woman hiding.
Yeah.
What's
it's written in Russian? Thank you.
written in same stuff that's written in a different language.
Blue one, so it would look better with skinnier straps. But I needed a new one anyway. I got all of the guys.
But maybe have some people in it, otherwise it would look boring.
No, you gotta go up higher.
No, it's okay.
Yeah. That's not the first time. That's the first time, right?
Yeah.
So he hadn't changed the diaper yet before.
Well, he did last Sunday, or whenever we were there.
He was teaching him how to do it?
Yeah.
How hard?
No, that's a real section of the wall, but the actual...
Ready?
team.
Morning.
Well, it's Sunday, August 5th. We're just eating breakfast. 6:23 right now. We came down at 6 o'clock in the morning. Yesterday, we woke up and came down for breakfast at 6. And then what we did is we went and bought 4 day passes. And from there, we went down to the Trip Parlor Park, which had the Trip Tower Park, which had the memorial to the Russians. And it was quite a nice monument. And then after that, Mom, what did we do?
We went to the museum.
We went to the Stasi Museum. So we went to like Friedrichstrasse and got off and walked towards that. And then we saw the site of where Hitler's chancellery was and then Hitler's bunker was. And then we went to Potsdamer Platz and went to the big shopping mall. And then we went to Charlottenburg. And we walked through there, and then we went to the airport, and Don and I changed our ticket so we can go home 1 hour earlier.
Well, not really go home, just leave Berlin.
Having a good time, are you?
And then Donna felt ill.
Too much walking.
And then Mom told her maybe she's ill for a good reason.
Right.
And then we came home back to the hotel. We were all pretty tired. And
how many hours were we out?
About 12 hours.
That's a lot.
And then we did a lot of walking yesterday, so then we all took showers and went to bed early.
We had a beer first.
Mom and Dad had a beer. Don and I, we took showers and then went to bed. I think I went to sleep about 8:30.
No, before that.
And then I woke up about 12:45 and then probably couldn't fall back asleep till at least 3. And then here we are having breakfast. And then, of course, when you stand up, did you guys go first thing? You need to stand up in the morning. Your feet are like bones are a little bit sore in the feet.
I don't know, but
today we're going to go to Potsdam. And then yesterday we also bought our rail tickets to go into Poland. Okay, that's about it.
Time goes by so fast.
Yes, I'm tired.
Not good to talk on this part because there'll be music.
Black Forest, yeah. And that other one that we bought there at the car.
Humans. Stepped on a... So there's poop right there.
They just laid down those bricks in the old way.
Shot somewhere.
I have that antibacterial
gel.
Gel.
No thanks.
There's a car between you, Robert.
Okay.
Right behind you.
You know what? I should pull my hat out.
So do you think somebody lives in that stuff over there?
No, I think there's a museum.
Yeah, I think it's a museum of some sort of museum. That's my guess.
Yeah.
It's not the pal
thing that we left with my mom and dad.
And there, that's when the lightning came over. See the big tour bus, Mom?
Yeah.
So Buddha's enjoying himself over there.
Yeah, let's go straight over there to the far end, maybe go down the middle. All you do is put them in the frame, don't worry about those grid lines. Yeah.
No.
Doesn't matter, whatever.
Plastic bird?
I can't look.
Mean one over there. But then this one must be a pretty mean one, the way it's got the waterfall in front of it.
About 60 kilometres south of Alice Springs by a group of Aboriginal people. They're not yet revealing how old the man was or the cause of death, but they have said that the dead man was wearing clothes different to those worn by Peter Falconio, not ruling out some connection to the incident when he disappeared, but so far they've been very...
Near Alice Springs, which is where Peter Falconio went missing, isn't it?
Take one of those rides on the
Yep.
Okay. sure it was clean enough.
Well, today being Monday, August 6th, it's 10:37 in the morning. We took the train this morning from Berlin. We got up at, some of us at 4:30, went down for breakfast at 6, ate till about 6:30, then caught the train from Berlin-Lichtenberg to Chechen, right here. And we got off the train, and some guy wanted to help us read the timetable. And he wanted money, so that's kind of made me mad on our first stop in Poland here, to have a negative thing. But then what we did is we walked up to our hotel with our backpacks, this hotel, Rysursky. And we are staying in here for one night. And we're paying 240 zloty. And Donna thinks it's about 20 more than it was last year. And she said that breakfast is served at 7 in the morning tomorrow morning. So we'll just pick up our passports from the front desk in a little while. And then what we'll do is we'll head to the tourist office and we'll walk around. It's sunny out and it's a little bit windy, which is going to be nice to keep it comfortable. So we'll walk around. Yesterday, who am I talking to? Yesterday we went to... we had breakfast, then we left, and we went up to Potsdam and walked around there all day. And that pretty much took the whole day. We came home, then we took a nap for about 3 hours. And then we went to the beer festival last night, which was pretty neat. Went forever, at least 2 kilometers of different pavilions of beer. And it would have been nice. Looks like there's choke cherries on this tree out here. Let me go pick one.
That would never be allowed at home. Where would he end?
Every time I pull this thing out, there's always someone who looks at me, and then their guitar coming towards me.
Who's
coming
towards you?
Well, probably during the days of communism.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
We got up this morning at 5 o'clock.
For someone who didn't want to do it, she's going to start.
Got up this morning at 5 o'clock in Berlin, and we went. We packed, and we went for breakfast at 5 to 6, and then we returned back to our rooms, finished packing, and left our room in Berlin, and headed for the train station, and take the train to Poland. It was Kathy and I's first time into crossing the border into Poland. It was exciting to be able to see a different country.
We wanted a German stamp on our passports, and the guy had to he had to enter it into his little computer, so he didn't want to, right? Because it's extra work. But he gave us all a stamp except for Donna. We said, "Forget it." Donna said it was okay not to get a stamp.
That was the Polish. It was the Russian one. I mean the German one.
That's the Ukrainian one. Yeah, German.
The German, what did I say?
Russian.
Okay. Anyway, we arrived in Poland in the town of...
Chechen? Yeah, Chechen.
Approximately around 10 o'clock. And we got off the train and we made our way. Donna and Robert have been here before, so they were able to... walk straight to the hotel that they intended to go, and here we are at that hotel. We unpacked, we threw off our packs, and the way we went into town, we walked all over town for approximately 4 hours,
following the little red lines and the arrows pointing to stuff.
That's right. There were red lines on the sidewalks, which with arrows. Indicating this is the way to see some of the town. The town itself is approximately 500,000 people, and so there is—it's quite a nice-sized town. There's a lot of things that Kathy and I noticed that were so different from Western Europe, and that was, all in the stores. Everything is behind counters. You walk into a liquor store; it's behind the counter. You walk into small grocery stores; it's behind the counter. And you kind of point to what you want. Okay, the only thing that's out in the open is the cheap stuff, like a water and a few other things. You can pick up yourself.
Tell us how much water costs.
I have no idea, Kathy.
We bought two waters, 1.5 liter waters, and it was $4.20 or something.
We returned
$4.40.
We returned back to our hotel room probably around 3 o'clock, and we rested for about an hour.
You had a beer.
Kathy and I had a beer, and then Robert and Donna, Kathy and I decided we would go to find something to eat, this time in some kind of a sort of a cafeteria-style restaurant.
Milk bar.
It's called a Milk Bar.
And this one came out of the Lonely Planet book. It's supposed to be the most popular.
And so we went to it, and we ordered Kathy and I's meal. Were totaled approximately 10, probably around $4.50.
Canadian, isn't that ridiculous?
Canadian.
So
what we eat for that money. We had borscht, put here with sour cream, malesnica, with cream and sugar on top. We were really full.
Yeah, the meal was we ordered too much.
Yeah.
I would have ordered lesser.
Yeah, order half. Like a bowl of borscht would have done me fine.
Yeah, a bowl of borscht would have been just fine.
You know?
Yep.
I told Ernie to take a bun, but...
If you order it at the window, you don't take.
Yeah, but the buns were way up at the other end.
And you just pull your bun out of your bag that you had.
So then we came back to the hotel for a little rest. And then we're probably going to walk down to the train station in a little while.
Yeah, we should do that pretty quick.
And then... Probably walk around a little more and come back and shower and
get to bed and rest again.
Yeah, and our train doesn't leave tomorrow till somewhere around 10, so.
And tomorrow morning's breakfast is at 7, so we'll have a little more leisure time at the breakfast table.
Yeah.
Which is nice.
Yeah. Okay.
And it's a pretty little restaurant downstairs for the breakfast, really cute.
Wrong language.
Stay open. But you're right.
And this was 2:20.
Yeah, but this is without breakfast.
Yeah, it's true.
So, you know, we'll get going here.
Yep.
I suppose the water's ours.
Yeah, it's natural.
You know, they're funny, you know. This in English here, this is awful for English.
Robert, help. I guess we gotta boot, you know. It's 6 o'clock now. 2 hours.
Oh, something stinging.
Do you have this one?
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello.
You want me to put that in Papa Donna's bag with her other one? Is it yours? Is this the same precious? Precious.
church.
Yeah, right. The church. Do is Demoral on the train, read the section, the Lonely Planet book.
Yeah, he was he built things, you know.
Czekamy na Szulskiego, jeżeli o to chodzi, i idziemy.
didn't have it, yeah. What do you think this is in a glass?
It's water.
Does it say natural on it?
Natural on the bottom, underneath the big word. Naturalina.
No, let me see something like that.
It's right there. Naturalina.
So this is just water?
Same water.
Well, today's Wednesday, August 8th. It's 10:30 in the morning. We caught the 7:05 train from Warsaw to Krakow. And we went to Hotel Polonia, where Donna and I stayed last year. And the guy said they didn't have any availability, so Donna suggested we went to this hotel next door, her old Hotel Warsaw. And they did have room, so we looked at their suite for $650. We looked at their one with a bathroom for $350. And then Dawn and I decided to get the one without a bathroom for $220 because we thought it would be same room but just without a bathroom. But it turns out that ours was unrenovated, so for $30 more, you're in nice comfort. And she actually gave us a room that's higher price for $400 because I guess she had no more availability or something. So, yesterday we arrived in Warsaw because Donna made the decision that it's raining up along the Baltic. So we went from Chechen to Warsaw, got in there at, I think we left at 8:40, and we arrived at like 2 o'clock. So we went to our hotel, and it was tough to get to our hotel because it was by bus. Had to buy our two tickets for the tram, bus. And then we walked the Royal Mile to the Old Town and did that, and then we went home that last night and slept, and the mosquitoes were biting. At least they were biting me. They didn't bite anyone else, it seems. And then we took the train here, so now we're here for 3 days. So what we plan to do is walk around the Old Town today. We have a full day here, and then tomorrow go to the salt mine, and then on Friday go to Auschwitz. And then after that, we'll go down to Zakopan. Anything you have to add, Donna?
Nope.
Nope. No fridge, though.
Sometimes
that's
with
right.
The
taping right now.
Well, that was refreshing.
Too.
Oh yeah. Oh, that's eating outside is the same restaurant?
I think so, mate. Paving now. You keep pulling that up.
Same thing, we are both
Yeah, but it's only 3:20.
But what day is it?
Today is Wednesday.
But it's past 15:00.
Go where Donna's going.
Yeah.
Watch my elbow, you guys.
Plus now we
right there is the old cemetery. You can go in there, and if we can't go in there today...
That's a Jewish cemetery?
Yeah.
Well, it's just going to be
nice to go into that, just so you can see it's an old one.
Why don't you go ask how much it is for Hotel Astor and I?
A lot of banks here. You can tell, you know, the cities.
Yeah, we should wait.
Because he knows, he thought that you think he...
Made an inkling that you thought it was him. Like, you didn't say that you knew it was him, but he had such a guilty conscience.
Another cat.
Donna, bring the book over here. This is the king's bedroom.
Coffee.
No.
Coffee.
Well, today is the 9th of August, 7:42 in the morning. We just went down for breakfast for 7 o'clock. And the breakfast was nice. They had a buffet. It wasn't too tasty, but I don't know. What do you do? Yesterday, we checked into the hotel and we went for a walk. Walked through the old town. Mom and Donna shopped through the cloth hall. Donna didn't buy anything. She plans to buy some stuff today. My mom bought a big jade, amber pendant.
And earrings.
And earrings. And then we walked around. We went to a milk bar. Had a plate of perha. Donna had four plates of perha.
Bye.
And then we went to walk down to the Wavel Castle. We went and stopped at a cafe for beer, and then we went to the Jewish ghetto Old Town District, and we walked through there. We went to the synagogue, went to that, saw some videos. Then we walked back here, did some laundry, and today, yeah, it rained last night, but I slept through it. Today it's sunny with some cloud out there, low cloud. I think it'll burn off. Today we're going to go to the salt mine, and then maybe we'll, after that we'll go to Flashoff concentration camp site. And then tomorrow we'll go to Auschwitz, and from there on Saturday we'll check out, we'll go to Zakopane. So we'll see how it goes. Alright. Yeah, well, that's double what we pay.
One flash.
My mother is working in the cell. Now we still get figures of high over, then we can see if we find from very high to me as we replace many times in the past. Now let's look at this white cell on the ceiling. I don't really confess for itself yet. Daughter of Bela IV, the King of Hungary, married Polish Prince Boleslas, and she asked her father about wedding gifts. She wanted to receive mummies too. One of them is methane is a gas dangerous because explosive. Of course, if somebody uses open fire. In the past, mummies working here use only open flames for interior. It was operated by technical experts. This mission is about two tanks. In that capacity, it's possible to see two other types of this machine actually. There are 172 from the top to the bottom of this chamber open. So keep smiling, please, and follow me. Some years ago, this figure stood near the fat his beard. Now this dwarf is without beard. And mine is afraid that for some time this figure.
What? Went to the bathroom.
Oh, she's back there?
Okay, I'll go.
Excuse me, I have to go.
See, they built this. I mean, Mom and then we're going to the shooting range. This is the jacket. I mean, see that woman right?
Yeah.
Oh, we could go this way.
Well, this is the old part of town, I see, Robert.
Yeah.
And then let's walk around the old part of town.
Talking about the timetable.
Why isn't it on 5 seconds?
We changed it.
It's a brick plant, right? It's a kiln, you think?
Yeah, but they could be, you know, with
a little lady who had the ice cream, look how good she's doing. Side to it?
Yep.
Well, that should take a few days.
Hope you brought a lunch. Yeah,
where are we walking to?
You can pass me.
That's what they'd be chipping away. You got to have rocks, or that, where they would, you know, cut up the rock here, chip it out. You'd either haul it someplace, you know, haul it out. What they have there?
Have it on the river
for cooling it.
Good, you know.
So you're saying you'd like to walk through there?
No, but we have to go up there. You know, they're not picking on me, so I'm not going to say anything.
I have a good idea. Let's cut through there and go through.
On the tree, just identify yourself.
From Rosebud.
cave.
Yeah, we can't climb up there. But what the
getting this done or she's leaving?
That's what I'm doing. I didn't zoom in.
Can we go around? Can we go this way?
Do it. And even if he disappears, that's... So, well, we'll stick here then.
I might have done that against the...
Yeah, someplace I read that.
Right, so maybe with so few that were left.
He's out of the church tower. He actually opens up the door, Mom. He's up there.
Where?
Oh, there's a window up there. Probably in that left-hand tower.
Thank you.
Street.
You can't get through there.
I already did.
Sinistra, tutti a sinistra per favore. Non scappa dei voti.
Andiamo tutti a sinistra.
Yesterday had that big bombing, and killed 16. Now they changed it this morning to 16.
But there were still some in the hospital that they didn't know whether or not would survive. What'd they do?
They sit in their airplanes.
To they just slept upon each other. Ken? Six?
Belongs to all nationalities. It's an idea that is very
scary. It wasn't
scary.
The Germans that did that?
Well, no, it's the Nazis, not the German people.
Well,
but the
it was the yeah. It's the fifth nationality that communism belonged to.
Oh, wow.